UGS. Earl's up there, Big Mac's up there, Yumi's here, guys who have been doing well. And then, yeah, right in that middle level, we got Gus, Abe, Super, Santi. I entered bracket today.
Oh, really?
You're in bracket. Yeah, I'm
playing today. We got the mid-level competition is going to be insane today.
Yeah, but we're going to get underway with some Smash 4 versus Smash Ultimate DLC.
This looks like a match you'd see on a Twitter meme of, like, can you believe Smash Ultimate's a real game?
Yeah, like, if you show this to somebody in 1999 and go, this is going to be Smash Brothers, excuse me? What is that? Well, actually, you know, they might believe Banjo back in 2000.
They would have been like, wow. Oh, my God, I don't know what you're talking. I don't see a Banjo on screen right now. That was...
Which Smash game is this?
Yeah.
What year is it?
Yo, great combos coming through from L&O.
Yeah,
nice little string together.
Korja, on the other hand, playing the Banjo, didn't really seem like he knew how to DI the Bayo combos. And to be honest, that's becoming like a lost piece of knowledge in this game. You don't run into Bayo very often anymore.
It really is, man. She poses a big threat to a lot of players who are coming in new to Ultimate. And right now, we're seeing some good combo strings together. And also, just kind of the lack of understanding of, like, unfortunate. Finally loses that stock there, but like a very defensive game can be forced by Bayo's play, because Japan just has to sit there and then anti-air with her entire kit.
Yeah, she makes it a little bit more difficult to approach than you would think, but Korja really just not really knowing the DI. You got a DI up and away. You know, people used to say, oh, you got SDI, 23 degree angle, mash really hard, break your controller, and then maybe she won't kill you. Well, Bayo is now a very different character that, while not being a very tippity-toppity high tier, can still function as we're seeing in certain situations. We saw the good ladder combo to begin with. She does still have a couple of kill options, not nearly as good as they were, but Witch Time can still lead to a smash attack kill. Back air is going to kill early, and eventually forward throw will kill at the ledge. And that down air,
yeah.
The one that people never want to talk about.
Yeah, down air, like, started out strong in Ultimate. It was like it was her best kill move, in my opinion. And she's only gotten more options as, like, people kind of relearned her. And it's really interesting to see how her meta's developed with players like L&O and Rose being kind of the forefront.
Yeah, that's at art in Chicago. And then you got guys in the national scene, Geist probably being the real champion of Bayo in terms of who's doing what in the national scene.
Oh, yeah.
I got to play against Geist at Smash and Splash.
Oh, how was that?
He is very good.
Yeah, I Tameem was actually in my pools for Big House. I don't know if you heard. Lost to a hero round one and DQ'd himself.
Oh. Yeah, see, that is unfortunate to hear, but a lot of the Bayo players have decided they're going to play other characters, and that is a really good answer to Wonder Wing.
Yeah, great job not getting too overeager and trying to punish it while it still had its invincibility. That was a nice patient punish there. And, I mean, patience is kind of the name of the game when you play Bayo. You cannot, for both cases, really.
I love the option, not just the Witch Time, but the knowledge I'm going to jump over you and smash attack the other way.
Yeah.
Knowing that it would reach, knowing that Banjo was going to have to come to the end of his Wonder Wing distance, and knowing that he was going to time that the right way. It was all very impressive looking from L&O here in this round one.
Yeah. I'm wondering how Korja, you know, a lot of Banjos will have a secondary. No? All right. He's sticking with the B and K, the Banjo and Kazooie here. So I'm excited to see what kind of counterplay he can drum up. I'd like to see a lot more just kind of projectile, a little lazier of a play style, a little more laid back. Because right now he's been approaching, he's been trying to attack on shield, and he's been getting punished for it.
Yeah, Banjo and Korja just had a little bit of a difficult time getting in on Bayo, because every time he's gotten close, Bayo's punished him heavily. He's got to know when, really, to throw out projectiles, I feel, is the problem. Because he starts the games with a couple projectiles, and then he forgets that's what you need to do. And when he remembers, oh yeah, I do kind of need to projectile this character, his timing's been off. But this stage should serve his purpose a lot better if he plays the platforms right. See what he does, as he's been doing so far so good, but he is still losing in damage despite that. But Banjo, being a DLC character, no surprise, can kill you super early.
You're saying that Wonder Ring almost taken out that stock, and I think it was at 42%.
Yeah, wow,
nice little pseudo confirm there.
Sorry, I didn't mean to see into the future there, but here we are.
Calm down with the commentating, dude.
All right, good Wonder Wing. That's a good jump catch read. Smart by Korja. That's a good adaptation.
Yeah, and a lot of people were kind of wary about, or are trying to be wary about Wonder Wing, because it doesn't have any real confirms, and it kind of relies on a read or a punish, but when you get that read, it's one of the most bang for your buck moves.
Yeah, it probably is the most bang for your buck move in the game in terms of reads. It's like right up there with Ridley's F Smash.
Oh,
yeah. With moves that can just delete you.
Yeah, it does what, 30%?
Wonder Wing?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I know it does a considerably high amount.
Yeah.
I don't think it's 30.
Oh,
that was really nice.
That was cheeky.
F tilt into grenade. He couldn't quite get the follow-up. Playing doubles by himself here.
Yeah, trying to get those fun item combos. And that's all bats within to get around the back air, but...
Ooh. That would explain why you're pretty decent at doubles, actually. Because you play Dedede, so you're trying to bank people off of, like, Gordo into hit you.
Yeah, I mean, it also just helps that Gordo is so degenerate in doubles. It just hits everybody and then I win.
Oh, Bird Bash, not the punish that he was looking for. Sometimes you just gotta hit them and know that you're not gonna be able to get the kill just because they whiffed on something big. Corda, though, you can't really blame him. He is playing from behind here. He's down a game, down a stock. Tail as old as time.
Oh, yeah. And yeah, I knew someone had picked up the grenade. I couldn't tell who it was. I'll break up the combo. He's getting a little bit greedy here, and he's already lost two Wonder Wings. And he needs, I think he's going to need one to confirm this stock. So
he's got a few ways he can take this stock, but he's going to need one if he wants to steal the game, I think. I agree with that 100%. He's not just going to get like a random crazy combo non-Wonder Wing kill. But I would like to see him go for like a down throw or something, and that wastes another one. It may not matter here.
Wow, LNO just dragging him all the way.
Side. Wow.
Yeah, great string from LNO to clean up that stock.
Feo doesn't need buffs. Everybody stop it right now.
It's like people who ask for Marth buffs. Like, he's got everything he needs. It's just he takes more work.
Well, Marth is strange. That's a different one. I'll get back to that in a sec.
But okay.
Bayo specifically, when you can still do things like that, you see all these Bayos, they'll throw out a combo, do like 90%, and be like, the character doesn't work. Like,
oh, yeah.
Stop it. Stop immediately. That's